بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. All praise is due to Allah, and may Allah's peace and blessings be on Prophet Muhammad and all the prophets. May Allah's peace and blessings be on all of them. Dear respected viewers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Peace be unto you all. This is your brother Amr Dabour sharing some thoughts with you. Ramadan is the month of fasting, and fasting is not just like some rules, some hard, rigid rules to do. Yes, it's full of rules, and everybody of us should learn how to fast, should ask, should have some counselors, some shuyukh, some imam, to have access to the people of knowledge to ask about it and be, you know, informed and study how to fast and how to do it in the way of Islam, the best way, the way of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yet, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not want to have hardship, to impose hardship on people by giving them the actions of ibadah like fasting and prayer and so on. Rather, to make the life of people easier and to give reward to people. That's why if somebody out of forgetfulness, somebody forgets and eats or drinks while fasting, obviously you break your fasting. Your fasting is gone. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he didn't do it intentionally, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, does not count that. This does not count. If you eat or drink while fasting, it does not count. Your fasting is still valid. There is no problem whatsoever. Even if you have eaten a lot, you have, you know, drank a lot of water or so, doesn't count with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِذَا نَسِيَ فَأَكَلَ أَوْ شَرِبَ وَهُوَ صَائِمٌ. If you forget, eat or drink while fasting, فَلْيُتِمَّ صَوْمَهُ. You have to continue your fasting, there is no problem. فَإِنَّمَا أَطْعَمَهُ اللَّهُ وَسَقَاهُ. It's only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who provided you with food and water. See how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is merciful. How rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, are easy to be applied. It's not just like you have to do that from that time to this time and it's very strict and very tough. It's not like that. It's for us. It's not against us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might give somebody rizq if you forget and eat or drink. At the same time, to see how simple is Islam and the rules of fasting and all the rules of Islam, you can, if you need, for maybe have some like chef or something, or a woman, you know, cooking at home, you can taste. You can taste the food to see if it's salty or not without swallowing anything. You can taste it. No problem. You can have madmada and istinshaq, rinsing the water and sniffing water while having wudu or so, but do not do it much. Do not make mubalagha. Don't do it much while fasting. Just, you know, quickly like that, so that water will not get in. You'll not swallow any water. In a nutshell, siyam or fasting, like all the other rules of Islam, is very simple. Is very easy. The spirit of law is there. If you miss any of it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, will not count this for you. As long as you have sought knowledge at the beginning, you study fasting and the rules of fasting, because some people, unfortunately, they have access to knowledgeable people, they have good imams, they have, you know, access to shuyukh and imams, maybe through the internet or on the phone or on TV channels like that, but they are very lazy. They don't bother to ask or learn, or, you know, they just get to it like this. And this is very clear in Hajj, for example. No, don't do that. Don't do that. Learn and study and apply the rule of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If any mistake happens, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving. He will forgive. He doesn't count anything like that. Thank you so much. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.